Hello, I'm Organic Conrad here in the Hawaiian Sanctuary kitchen. We are going to go mad with the cacao pods. And maybe explain a little exactly what we said about shrinking the pods exactly, or the seeds.
What we're going to do is we're going to open them up and then we're going to shrink them in the dehydrator on slow heat. So low heat, so it's going to be still raw. So I'm just cleaning the pod right now. So
okay,
yeah,
we're calling this a podcast.
But we're going to work. This is the cacao podcast.
Cacao podcast, get it?
Yeah.
Pod. Check out my fingers closer.
Cacao pod.
The podcast.
The podcast. Don't ask why we're on live microphone. It's because that's how we roll now.
Say, Crutch's voice wasn't loud enough, he needed some kind of assistance.
Two men, one Garden of Eden. One afternoon, one man from Jamaica. 14 cacao pods.
Yeah. Oh man.
Ryan's so much better. We need Ryan here. Ryan would be to go off on it. My brother's a stand-up comic.
Oh.
He's been known for years.
Really?
Yeah. It's probably been his living for a long time.
Let's make him proud.
Okay, I'm gonna.
Yeah,
I'm gonna
step in here and
okay.
The,
David is now clearing the cacao beans from the pot. This is one of the first times I've really seen professionals work with the fruit.
What you
fruit?
Can do is just squish it down. Yeah, okay. It's a fruit right now and a seed.
A fruit,
yeah.
And a seed.
You're working through it.
Yeah.
Okay, he's using a spoon to scrape the fruit seeds out onto a flat tray that will then be inserted into the dehydration mechanism, which is standing behind us over here. Kind of take us through the process, just it's kind of encapsulated for a second, if you will.
So what we're doing is opening the pod, and then on the inside there's all this fruit. So there's two ways to go about this. We're going to do dehydration, and then we're also going to do a fruit juice extract after this.
Wow, okay.
So,
two processes. I'm hearing about two processes.
So this is what you got on the tray. See? We got it all on the tray right here.
It's all on the tray.
And it's going to go in the dehydrator.
As the French would say, tray bon.
Bon appetit.
Oh.
Voulez-vous coucher avec moi ce soir?
Okay, and then we're going to add some to this jar.
Okay, we're going to put it in the jar.
Yeah,
and this is for the...
this is going to be a fruit juice
this
extract.
This is the juice extract. Okay,
yeah.
Maybe let me do this one.
Okay. You know, I don't think you need the microphone.
You don't think I need the microphone for this one?
We'll put it down for a little bit.
I'll just kind of put it in my mouth, man.
Eat the microphone.
Wash my paws.
So if you never heard of cacao before, cacao is where chocolate comes from.
That's true.
So it's really quite interesting to believe that.
I didn't know that.
That it would start off looking like this. And it looked like that.
It's like this.
And then end up looking brown like chocolate.
A lot of people do not know that this is chocolate. This is where chocolate comes from. I mean, that's where chocolate comes from. I think so.
That's where chocolate comes from.
This is where chocolate comes from. Before I came to Hawaii, I didn't know that. I hadn't really integrated with a cacao plant before.
Nice.
So, all right. It's all mushy and gooey. It feels like a really nice, probably a nice skin. Probably that's in your skin to rub it all over yourself when you make it. What do you think, David?
Yes, this would be wonderful to take a bath in. Yeah.
Cacao bath.
It might be good for your skin. It's actually like put it on
sure.
Your face. You know, like a facial, like
chocolate
serum.
Facial.
It's
a feel like
cacao facial serum.
A facial.
You just rub it all over your face.
Well, when you drink something, you absorb it properly. But when you put it on your skin, you're absorbing it too in a much more efficient way. Sometimes it goes directly into your blood cells, right into your organs.
Well, and then right out your butt.
Yeah.
Hey, are these are sprouting? These are life.
No, you can actually take these sprout ones and you're gonna grow a tree.
Oh my god.
These are the ones that you take out and you grow a tree.
We
are
making
two different beverages.
Yeah,
great.
Look.
Growing this is the real reason
look.
That I came down here.
Oh,
was to
there
get
it
some
is.
Sprouts.
Oh, there it is.
You know what?
There it is.
I'll go home and plant those today.
Someone called me Noah the other day and I was like, I'm gonna plant two of every tree.
The circle of life, everyone.
Because I guess someone else has put a quote and it says, we need to eat the animals. Noah didn't save any plants on his ship. I'm like, what? How could he not have, who did the animals eat then? Like, no, bad quote.
But speaking of taking care of things, the cacao tree, right? It needs more dryness than I thought. You can't get too wet or it starts to rot.
Too much of anything is not good.
It needs like a
balance of everything.
Right, you can even have too much durian, can you believe that?
I don't know about that. How does it do with direct sunlight, this baby plant? Not good? Right?
Gotta
grow it for a while?
It can take full sun.
It can.
But it has to be, you know, brought up. So
plant it maybe in a pot until it's like, I don't know, a foot high or something? And then,
that's juicy, that's strong.
Yeah. Awesome.
This is a tropical tree.
Tropical tree.
There's lots of good vitamins. Fruit, very delicious.
Right,
it's a superfood, right?
Yeah.
Another
tree
and the dehydrator?
Yeah. Yeah, so in here, and then we'll put some water in there. And it's good. We're gonna make a fruit juice extract.
Oh wow!
And then we're gonna squeeze that juice, and we're gonna drink it as a nectar, the nectar juice of the cacao.
Cacao nectar juice.
Yes, and that's what we're gonna go with.
And that's kind of thing.
That's gonna be our treat after this whole thing. We're gonna let it sit for about 30 minutes to an hour, and then we're gonna put in the sun, and we're gonna squeeze all that juice out.
Maybe squeeze it with lemon. What we'll do is lemon. We'll get some coconuts, we'll open some coconuts, put coconut milk in there, and lemon juice, and then we'll squeeze it all out together. It'll be coconut, lemon, cacao juice.
Sounds amazing. And then the sweetness of the cacao will just overpower it.
Yeah.
Never tried.
You know the best.
I can wait. No such thing as the word can.
You know the best juices I've ever had. Literally, it was just pure pressed marijuana leaves.
Yeah.
You tried that?
Yeah, that's the best.
Only had it once.
The whole
thing.
Pass, right?
Yeah, your stuff. I thought that was. Well, we're having it with
watermelon
and lychee.
Oh, and lychee, nice. Lychee season. Oh.
We got lychee.
Oh, Simone. Hakuna Matata. Thanks, Simone. There's a really interesting learning process opening these different types of cacao here.
Yeah. The best way is this way. Look. You got like this, and it's click. Oh, it's like this, and it's click.
I mean, we're in the kind of place where I have to Why? When he was a young one,
He found his aroma like a certain appeal. Where chocolate comes from, I don't know.
We're making beans, right?
Yeah.
I saw him come in before.
No worries for the rest of your days. It's all problem-free, philosophy, Hakuna Matata.
Can you tell he's had kids?
I don't know. Is that a
What do you mean? I was a kid when this movie came out. This is just you're 60 years old, man.
At least 10.
God.
Couldn't have been that.
Well, when did this movie come out? What, like 98 or something? I was going to say
at least 92.
Oh.
But the new one, and we got 10. The new one too.
Right? Oh, the new one. Oh, the new Jungle Book? I haven't seen that one.
Yeah.
Is it good?
Yeah, it's really good.
No, no, the new Lion King. The new Lion King.
Oh, yeah.
The new one?
Yeah. What else? Please do the same music.
Yeah.
That's a creepy one. Yeah, that's a
creepy one.
That one's a little darker over there.
It's kind of nice. You alright? Want to play that?
Yeah, it'd be fun.
What do you
think of this?
Red?
Yeah, that would be fun.
Philosophy. You're having a Hakuna Matata day on there, Steve. No problems today so far.
Steve, I think you grew this stuff, huh?
No, the nature did.
Right, but you planted it.
I'm out of here.
Yeah, we didn't want nature to grow.
Did you know you're completely months. Off Facebook now?
I know.
They completely shut down your account.
I know. No wonder I'm getting so many views. They're going to watch my channel to see you now.
I do want to get these views. Did you see the video? I shot a video. I was like, you know what? This is ridiculous. I was born naked, and I can't be naked. And I can't. No one can see how I was born. I'm like, here I am. Take a look. This is nothing illegal about this. And if there is, I shouldn't be on Facebook. So I guess someone heard that.
Yeah, I have that who I'm not friends with anymore app, and your name came up again.
Oh.
And it said, and it looked like your profile was completely eliminated.
Well, thank God. All I can say. I'm moving on. I'm going long form.
Going Twitter.
So here's, I want to give you guys a little bit of secret while you're doing that.
Okay.
Under no circumstances do you want to cut into the beans at all.
Yeah, you want to do that. You don't want to do like this, like that and a click.
Got you.
Yeah.
I'm messing it up.
Oh. Because then you release what? You release on the app.
Yeah, what I recommend is cutting the ends off, and then they just push them right out.
Oh, no kidding. Okay, let me see.
All right,
so you're like... There?
Yeah.
There's two beans right there. I've got the knife in here, yeah.
And he's cut the top off?
Cut the top off.
So it's going to affect the flavor because some of those acids or whatever.
Yeah. You don't want to cut the...
So you always keep cutting down until you get to the white? Or
yeah, then when you cut it down, then you do the middle.
I guess you
just... That's why it's better off not to use knives at all.
Yeah, you'd actually...
And just like have a little special crush or something that just crushes them and the parts.
Mm. Well, you have a touch. You develop a touch, but you're not harming the beans. I can see that.
Oh. That's another way to do it. You break
the crushing
system,
that's what I'm saying. Oh, right, that's okay. The way, like the coconuts.
Necessities, but simple bare necessities. Forget about your worries and just try. I mean the bare necessities or Mother Nature's recipes that bring the bare necessities of life.
The cacao ceremony. Used to be, I missed your cacao ceremony.
We're going to bring it. We've been serving cacao every Friday.
Yeah,
we sell a jar, yeah.
Okay.
Wonderful, look at that.
Oh,
wait, boom. Wash it?
It's red. Blue jungle. Yeah,
it's not that good. Do
you have a navy app? Everybody. It's in my room. If I do. It's Jen's old stuff.
Jen. Magic came
leaving
food
back
here.
Yeah.
Noni
shot.
My little mole.
Or two.
Bowl of marijuana.
Well, that's my favorite.
You want
a noni
right?
shot?
Yeah. Noni shot? Or a turmeric shot? Turmeric? Right there.
I think a noni shot would be
right there in my little bum bag. Little
I
pint.
Do have that on my own too. I just try. I was thinking back here working. I was trying to keep my mental.
Gotcha. Yeah. Painkiller without the.
I got to go with Sativa.
But that's generally my.
I'm gonna go see if I have that one.
If you do that,
would that be awesome? Okay. I'm going to have this book with you, and I have
a few
more things that we have together, and one of the things that
you are.
Okay, perfect.
Thank you.
Ooh,
that's
awesome.
Well,
this stuff is like,
oh,
this needs to be
resolved.
Yeah, you can do a CBD espresso.
That sounds like an oxymoron. I know. There are two A's at the same time.
So we have espresso, we have CBD. There's no. I think it will. I think I might do one too.
I mean, I used to do it more like.
Oh, it was great. Yeah, the whole time. I love that type of music. I got a lot of stuff like that too. I got a little bit of old school dance music, like funk and
the funk.
Yeah.
I know. I have to kick
off.
Excuse
me, I'm
kicked off for nudity. People really gotta fit if you're not clothes. So ingrained in us.
What?
The people are, it's so ingrained in us that it's not okay to be, you must have clothes.
I know, we were just talking about how you got banned from Facebook for being naked. We should all be able to go naked all the time.
Oh no, I was raised like that it was okay to be naked.
Yeah.
Just
oh, you
in
were?
A certified kitchen that we couldn't be because I know the laws.
Yeah.
That's what I was saying.
I know, but I don't believe in certified kitchens.
No, the laws where I come from, which is the East Coast, if you don't go to Indians, you get arrested.
Yeah, in Minnesota you don't really either, but I grew up with a family that was more liberal than that.
Oh, really? Yeah. I grew up in a liberal enclave, but still, we would never go naked. This wasn't done.
I grew up in Scotland and we're fucking free!
It's crazy. Our relationship with being naked is so unhealthy. It's crazy.
As a society,
as a whole. The nakedness is akin to violence. Oh, we treat it the same way. The penalties for being naked are almost the same as being violent. It's crazy. It's really weird, and we wonder why we have so many problems with violence and everything. We already created the naked, the body as being violent.
When I found Kalani, and that it was a place that I could be naked, I was pretty much sold.
Yeah, great.
Man, there wasn't one naked person there.
Really?
No, they made the egg could be topless.
No, they said for this private event that there were no rules about clothes at the pool.
Oh, that's cool.
Really?
Mm-hmm. That was what they posted in the thing about it. I was actually surprised.
That's cool. Usually on Sundays you can go topless, but you need a
bottom.
Yeah,
I know that you have to go bottoms now.
We do.
Except for if you're there before hours.
Okay, that was the ecstatic dance rule. Someone said that in ecstatic dance.
Can you make another coconut?
Oh, there's Nettie. Don't worry about it. I'll have it out here. Okay, don't worry. I don't even think I should get extra work here.
But like, Facebook banned me for being naked on a nude beach.
We're going to make some coconut milk anyway.
Are we going to make some?
It's so crazy.
Yeah, I can switch gear and do some coconut. So we can make some.
You're welcome.
Be sure to what ails me, I'm certain.
How are you guys looking?
Yeah. It's Puna's newest cooking show.
Is it a time lapse?
It's a long form cooking show. Once in a while we remember that the camera's going and we come up. Okay, we've now been filming for almost 20 minutes.
Should we take a little break and then come back to the other processes?
Well, if you're doing a time lapse.
Is it a time lapse?
I don't know if it's, I mean, it could be.
No, this is a video.
Yeah, it's a video. We just document everything.
Okay,
you can
edit it later.
Oh, you can edit it.
Wow.
I'm gonna edit stuff. I use top quality. We're already here with this camera. Let me edit stuff. The aspect ratio is all wrong. You need widescreen. You're gonna go epic high quality. David, thank you so much for such a great experience.
Yeah, right? Super fun, huh?
In Hilo. He's got a show coming up at the end of this month, I think. Dude, have you ever really powwowed with him?
Yeah.
God, is he cool. He's so intense.
I know, right? So how many more pods are ripe out there? Is this it?
This is all, are there more trees?
There's more out there somewhere.
I don't think we hit all the trees.
Yeah.
Because 200 trees, we definitely didn't hit 200 trees, I don't think. So how many you got, 200 trees?
200 trees!
Wow. Wait, are there more areas where they're at?
Yeah, in the front and the back, and there's another road. Yeah, in the back. So.
That's true. Right.
Yeah, that's it.
Little secret, you ready?
Yeah, I did.
This little secret. Just go. That. That.
Oh wow.
So it's kind of like you put the pressure on. You know?
Still good, huh?
Yeah.
You put a little bit of pressure on.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. So just it's like click. Yep. Like a quick key. Yeah. See? Yeah. Just key it out. We need to make a mate. You do a mana mate?
Yeah.
Let's make another mate. Nice.
There it goes.
He's developing like a gentler technique now. It's funny, he opened up one the other day. We were so gentle. The banging was so gentle.
Yeah.
He's showing his child how to do it.
He go out, come on.
Alright, what's next?
Here we go.
So
so great. It's so great to have the equipment. I'm gonna just do it.
Yeah. This, you know what's cool? What we could do if that dehydrates really good, mm-hmm. it really dries out. You could put those in here, and it'll be purple chocolate. We can go that far.
Okay.
We can literally go to the level where we're making purple chocolate, completely raw purple chocolate.
It's like liquid chocolate?
Ah! With the stone grinder. It'll be creamier. The thing is, it can't be like a temper. It won't be tempered. It'll be creamy purple cacao with white butter, and then we add honey to so make it pure.
And it lasts, though, even if it's pure.
Yeah.
Right. Would you have a blender that you make your coconut milk in?
Yeah. Should we pop them open and then...
Guess what? I want to know where I'm going to put the water. We should right into that jar.
Yeah, we should do the water mix. That is how we would do a mix.
Do that jar?
Yeah.
Okay, I need to do it by the way. Competition.
Yeah.
Live on Facebook.
Nice. We're up against ourselves.
Okay.
Yeah.
I hope you don't lose.
Well, you know, it's always a possibility.
Which one is it? Adam.
What's your name?
Conrad.
Conrad and
Crunchy.
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 Adam. Adam. Adam.
Why are you looking at me, man?
Okay, we're gonna do juicing.
Wow, that's an amazing combo.
Oh my god. Okay, oh, the stem. Yeah, right? There's probably something in there, huh?
Something in the whole stem is
there. There's something in there. There's probably some other property or something.
Spine.
Yeah, it's your spinal cord. Maybe it's good for your spinal cord.
There you go.
Right? The cacao and the spinal cord. Nervous system. The nervous system.
They're so good with the coconut meat.
Absolutely delicious. Breathtaking. Out of this world.
That is good.
It's like
you go to the store and you buy a chocolate bar with coconut milk.
It's like this, that's like the freshest raw version of that.
So that's what we're going to do, coconut, lemon, lime, extract. We're going to squeeze that and see how it comes out. There are forces combined stuff.
Fresh fruit, something about freshness. Freshness, you know?
Right.
How long does it last for before it like starts to lose up?
I would say like a week, 2 weeks.
That's not bad.
Wow. When you have the vines, the tree's growing in your backyard, you don't even pick it until you use it.
Yeah. Oh, battery low.
There goes the shed.
That's it.
Almost done.
Dude, it's gonna be so funny. We got Rory in here. Some mics on us. These are just so fun to have,
oh
right?
Oh my god, that's the one to have. Yeah, I have a little thingy juicer at home. But
yeah. Try it. It's super fun.
Come on, this is good. Look at that!
Oh, shit! Yeah, it's like, here it's like,
Wow, and it's all the juice is gone. Look at that.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.